Welcome to another video. Today we have a look at a way to water your garden and your plants in a way that doesn't waste water and also it's efficient for the plants, so the plants get the water as much as they need when they need it. The way I show you here is very simple. It uses just the plastic bottles, and this is it looks like a water cooler. You see, the water just comes out slowly out of the bottle. You decide by making the holes in the cup. This is just a simple water bottle turned upside down, and with holes in the cup, you either make the holes with the hot needle or with a knife. You can use something sharp to make the holes. The more holes you make, the faster the water will drain. So if you make 3, 4, 5 holes, you can slowly give this plant water for a few days. Here you see I didn't take care of these plants very well lately, and you can see that, but they're turning pretty well now. So this is lavender, and the bottle is there, feeding it, giving it water. And the best part is that the water is not on the surface, it goes a bit deeper in the soil, so it goes closer to the roots where they need the water. This is like a water cooler. You see the air coming out. And sometimes it's doing this when it's coming out, and then it stops. You see now air comes out. And slowly as the pressure equalizes inside the bottle, it will stop, and then it comes out later. And this is perfect. This is what we need. See, slowly it slows down, and then it stops, and later it will do it again. And this is all very simple, just with a plastic bottle. There is another way you can use. I give it a thumbs up. There is another way you can use a timer for this. There are timers available, and you can check the links in the description. Find the links in the description, go there. And if you don't want to use the plastic bottles and you want to have something more efficient, more fancy, a timer is perfect. But if you just want the plastic bottle, just use the plastic bottle. It's up to you. You can put one or two, even two plastic bottles for each plant. Normally you would change these bottles every few days, so 3-4 days the bottle will be empty, and then change it, put a new one. The nice thing about these bottles is that the water comes out slowly, so the plant gets water, but not too much at a time, so it feeds it in a good way. Some plants prefer it like this. If you want to use the timer, check the links in the description. They help us, and you also, you don't pay more, and you might even get a better deal like this. I update the links pretty often. So that's how it looks like with the bottles. You see the one on the right here, it starts to grow more, the lavender, it starts to make more green leaves. It needs a bit more food, but okay. This one still, they could look worse, but okay, this is, it's not great, but look, it's there. Some basil, we have some basil, a few aloe, and small rosemary. Actually, it's not very small, it's pretty big now. A rosemary bush, and it starts to have flowers. Rosemary flowers. New leaves are growing on this lavender plant. And you see they're not very green, very deep green, so it needs a bit of food also. This one even has flowers. that's how the bottle works. You see, if you, I squeeze it a little bit, water comes out. And it sits there, and when the soil gets a bit drier, it comes out slowly, slowly. Even before the soil gets dry completely, it comes out, so it never really gets completely dry. This one is being squeezed. This happens, and if it happens, it's okay, it's normal. It's because the water comes out really fast and the bottle squeezes. This one, it's not so well. I did it with the, I cut the cup with the knife, and the water doesn't come out very well. So you have to squeeze the bottle when you make this. And when you squeeze, you see it's cut, it's not a hole with the hot needle. When you squeeze it, water should come out. If it doesn't come out, then it's a problem. It will not come out at all. For example, this one works perfectly. Look at it. Just as it should be. Squeeze a little bit and the water comes out. And when you put it back on the in the pot, don't put it very close to the plant so it doesn't damage it. Put it somewhere a bit far in the corner, and not very shallow but not very deep, you know, just enough so it can stay like that on its own. If you want to make sure the bottle stays straight, you can put a small stick on it, like a bamboo stick, and put the stick in the soil so it supports the bottle. But I don't really need them, that works pretty well like that. That's it, I hope you liked the video, and if you do, make sure to press the like button, and if you're not subscribed to this channel, make sure to subscribe and also press the bell, hit the bell to get notifications when we upload new videos. Share the video with your friends, tell your friends to subscribe to our channel, and let us know in the comments how it's going. If you use this, you can use this to water your plants all the time, and it's a way to save water and also improve how you deliver water to your plants. Thank you for watching. Subscribe, like and share, and I will see you next time. Bye.